Assalamu alaikum and good evening all of you. Before starting anything, I would like to share a famous spiritual quote which I always use to amplify my abilities. It goes like Imam Ali Raza quote from his father Imam Musa Qasim. He quote from his father Imam Jafar Sadiq. He quote from his father Imam Muhammad Baqir. He quote from his father Imam Zainul Abidin. He quote from his father Imam Hussain. He quote from his father Maula Ali. He quote from the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he said, "What faith is? Faith is knowing from your heart, expressing it through your tongue, and performing it with your organs." So whatever you do in life, faith is the basic necessity for everything. So starting from the next class, that is pyrazolones and pyrazoles. This is the lead molecule or typical structure of a pyrazolone, in which as a result of modification, three drugs are formed. So let's discuss the basic structure, then we will come to the modifications. This is an aromatic ring which is attached to a five-membered complex ring in which two atoms are nitrogen while three atoms are carbon. Through this second member, that is nitrogen, a substitution is present which will decide the drugs. To the third member or carbon, a methyl substitution is present. To the fourth position, that is a carbon, another substitution is present which will decide the drugs. To the fifth position, a carbon is present which is present in the form of double bond with this oxygen. So this is the typical structure of a pyrazolone. This aromatic ring along with this ring contributes the drug's lipophilicity. These substitutions will decide the drug's kinetics and potency. This methyl here protects the ring and increases the potency, while this carbonyl is doing the same function as methyl, that is increasing the potency and giving stability to the chain. This is the first drug of pyrazolone class, that is pinazone. As we have discussed the structure of pyrazolone, in which aromatic ring is present, a complex ring is present with methyl and oxygen. The two substitutions which were present, that is R1 and R2, have been modified in this drug. That is, on the R1 position, that is on the second nitrogen of this chain, a methyl is substituted. However, to this fourth position, a hydrogen is present. This methyl will increase the drug's potency, will make it more lipophilic, and will increase the drug's kinetics, that is to stabilize it. The next drug is aminopyrine, which is very similar to the previous drug, that was pinazone. The only difference between aminopyrine and pinazone is on the fourth position. That is, on the pinazone, the fourth position was occupied by a hydrogen, but however, in aminopyrine, that hydrogen is replaced by a dimethyl nitrogen, which will increase the drug's potency towards the action of the drug and will make it more lipophilic and will increase the drug's stability. The third drug of this pyrazolone class is dipyrone, which is also similar to the previous two drugs of this class. The only difference between this dipyrone and the previous drug is on the fourth carbon. That is, in the pinazone, a hydrogen was present. In the aminopyrine, a dimethyl nitrogen was present, but in dipyrone, to the nitrogen, two carbon aliphatic chain is connected, to which a sodium sulfide substitution is present, which is making the drug stable in the form of a stable salt, which will ionize faster as in the case of dissolution. This aliphatic chain is increasing the drug's potency. However, this drug more ionizable and kinetically stable as compared to the other drugs. Now we will proceed to the pyrazone lead molecule and its drugs. So this is the lead molecule of pyrazole. We have discussed pyrazolones, now we will be discussing pyrazole. So this is the lead molecule of pyrazole, to which as a result of substitution three drugs will be formed. Pyrazoles are very similar to the pyrazolones, however three differences are present. First difference is that on the third carbon in pyrazolone a methyl substitution was present, but however in pyrazole on the third carbon a carbon double bonded oxygen substitution is present, that is a ketonic substitution is present rather than a methylic substitution. Second difference is that in between the third and fourth carbon there was a double bond. The double bond has been cleaved, which has developed a valency for this carbon to develop this double bond, and another valency is open at this carbon through which it has attached a hydrogen. However, the R2 substitution is additive. So these are the differences between pyrazolones and pyrazoles. The differences are substitution by a ketone on the methyl and the attachment of a hydrogen on the fourth carbon alongside this modification site, that is R2. Now we will discuss the drug. The first drug of pyrazole is phenylbutazone. What are the two differences on the modification site in phenylbutazone is that on the R1 position a phenyl substitution is present, which is also indicated by its name, and on the second modification site, that is R2, a butyl substitution is present. This phenyl and butyl groups are both increasing the drug's lipophilicity and this butyl group is also protecting these ketonic substitutions from biotransformation and biodegradation. So this was the first drug, phenylbutazone. The next drug of pyrazole is oxypenbutazone. There is only one difference between oxypenbutazone and phenylbutazone, that in phenylbutazone a phenyl substitution was present, but however in oxypenbutazone a phenolic substitution is present, that is only the addition of this hydroxyl group on the phenyl, it is converted into oxypenbutazone, or you can say that oxypenbutazone is an active metabolite that is produced during the phase 1 metabolism of phenylbutazone as a result of aromatic oxidation which has appeared as a phenol. So oxypenbutazone is an active metabolite as a result of biotransformation inside the body. The last drug of pyrazole class is sulfipyrazone. There are two differences in sulfipyrazone and the previous two drugs. That is, on the first modification side, in phenylbutazone, a phenyl substitution was present, while in oxypenbutazone, a phenolic substitution is present. But in this drug, that is sulfipyrazone, an alicyclic chain substitution is present. Six-membered chain of carbon, single bond, carbon to carbon, single bond ring system, which is known as alicyclic structure, is present. And on the second modification side, a phenyl is attached, to which a further sulfoxide substitution along with an ethyl substitution is present. These both rings are increasing the drug's potency and lipophilicity. However, the sulfoxide along with methyl is making it more potent as compared to the rest of the drugs of this class. Now coming towards the next class, that is oxychem. This is the typical structure of an oxychem, which is also known as 4-hydroxy-1,2-benzothiazine-carboxamide. This is the ring which is representing the name benzo. This ring is representing thiazide. 1,2-benzothiazide means that thiazide structure is maintained through the first and second position. Thiazide is a ring in which sulfur and nitrogen substitutions are present as a heteroatom. So 1,2-benzothiazide, and before that there was 4-hydroxy. So on the fourth position, a hydroxyl is present. So 4-hydroxy-1,2-benzothiazide-carboxamide. This carboxyl group with amide is known as carboxamide. So 4-hydroxy-1,2-benzothiazine-carboxamide. And to this carboxamide, a modification site is present, and according to the modification, there are two drugs in this class. This will be discussed now. This is the first drug of oxychem in which a pyridine substitution is attached to 4-hydroxy-1,2-benzothiazine-carboxamide structure. So this carboxamide has a modification, a pyridine modification is present. So what are the structural points? These two rings are, along with this ring, are contributing the drug's lipophilicity. This sulfur and nitrogen substitutions are increasing the drug's potency. This carboxamide is also increasing the drug's potency. However, this OH, which is also known as enolic OH, due to the presence of this double bond between the third and fourth carbon, because of the presence of a double bond between the third and fourth carbon, this hydroxyl is known as enolic hydroxyl or enolic OH. The NSAID effects of this class is achieved through this enolic OH, which acts as a proton donor and participates in enolate ion formation. Now we will discuss the next drug. The next and last drug of oxychem is meloxychem. The only difference between meloxychem and pyroxychem is the modification. That is, in pyroxychem, a pyridine substitution was present, but however, in meloxychem, a thiazide substitution is present, to which a methyl is substituted or present. So this methyl will protect this thiazide structure. The rest of the points are similar, that is, these rings will increase the drug's lipophilicity, these two drugs will increase the drug's potency, this carboxamide will also increase the drug's potency, this methyl will stabilize this thiazide ring. However, this enolic OH will give the NSAID effects to this class, for this drug. The next class is selective COX-2 inhibitors, in which we will discuss two drugs, that are celecoxib and melecoxib. So starting with the celecoxib, the typical structure of celecoxib is through a pyrazole ring. To this pyrazole ring, two phenyl substitutions are present. On total, to this pyrazole ring, three substitutions are present, that are 2-methyl, and third is the trifluorocarbon substitution. This is a trifluoro substitution, while these two are the phenyl substitutions. In this phenyl, a further sulfonamide substitution is present, and then this phenyl amethyl substitution is present. So coming towards the structural points, these all the three rings will provide the drug's lipophilicity. This trifluorocarbon being highly electronegative groups will protect the drug. This methyl will protect this aromatic ring, and this sulfonamide is responsible for the selective activity of this class. This sulfonamide specifically binds or produces hydrophilic interactions with the COX-2 enzyme, thereby specifying its action, that is selective COX-2 inhibition. So the selectivity is contributed to this sulfonamide substitution. So coming towards the last drug of this class, that is selective COX-2 inhibitor, that is malicoxib, and this is the last drug of NSAIDs also. So in malicoxib, a central furanose ring is present. In salicoxib, a pyrazole ring was the central ring to which two phenyl substitutions were present, but in here the central ring is furanose ring, that is 5-membered ring in which the hetero atom is oxygen. And to this furanose ring, a ketonic substitution is present. So two phenyl substitutions are present, like they were in the case of salicoxib. They are the same, that is two phenyl substitutions are present on furanose ring also. On one phenyl substitution, this sulfoxide substitution is present, which will develop hydrophilic interactions with the COX-2 enzyme, thereby making it selective for the COX-2. The rest points are same, that is these three rings will contribute the drug's lipophilicity. This ketonic substitution will make the drug more potent, and this methyl substitution will protect this sulfur system from degradation and biotransformation, and will make it more potent towards selectivity. So this was all about NSAIDs. Take care of yourself.